Oh God, I don't want to take up this call. You know why? Because he's my customer and I just don't want to talk to him right now. Interesting, right? Be honest with me. How many of you have said this to yourself when you've been in the same situation before, where your customer's calling you and at that point in time, you don't want to pick up the call and you just want to avoid it because you just fear what the customer's going to talk to you about and you don't want to deal with it. And let me first tell you that it happens. You know, customers can also be quite painful at times. I've always believed that it needs to be a win-win situation. And sometimes customers can be tough. Customers can be a pain in the wrong areas. I'm telling you, I've gone through it myself and I'm sure all of you have gone through it too. But I'll tell you what, let me share with you some observations which I have, which I've seen, you know, in my own business and obviously with a lot of other business owners when they share with me their concerns about their customers as to why people want to avoid talking to customers at times. It's a very funny behavior, but I think sharing these observations will help you get aware so you can deal with it differently, because at the end of the day, it's not a right thing to do. Let me be very clear. They're your customer. They need your attention and it's your duty and obligation to deal with them because they're paying you money, as simple as that. There's no other explanation required apart from that. Having said that, of course, you need to do it in the right way. So here are my observations as to why entrepreneurs and their teams avoid the calls of customers. Number one, because their customers are going to complain. And sometimes you feel that, oh my God, how do I deal with another complaint? Because you may feel if the complaint is valid, you don't want to face it. If the complaint is invalid, you have to deal with it. Let me tell you the consequence of avoiding a customer, especially when they want to complain. That complaint gets amplified. Even when that complaint was very, very small, at the end of the day, the biggest issue they'll have is that you're avoiding them, and that will become the surface of the conversation beyond anything else. What could be dealt by just providing a simple solution or fixing the matter at your end might just become a very big deal that you're not respecting them, because the customer will take it as disrespect and will feel that you're not giving the importance they deserve because they paid you money. It starts becoming about the money rather than the service. Okay, so be clear that you should pick up your customer's call, especially when they're complaining, rather than avoiding them, because that's the solution that will help them to solve that issue in their head and not keep dwelling about it, because people have the tendency to make things a big deal if it's not dealt with. It's about clarity. Another observation which I've seen where a lot of entrepreneurs avoid their customers' calls is because they feel that the customer's calling to bargain or to negotiate on the price you've offered to them. And I'll tell you what, I get your point. You don't want to entertain that conversation because, again, you don't want to get into a bargaining battle. Again, you don't want to get into justifying why you've priced or you've offered the quotation you have. But if you avoid that negotiation, what do you think is going to happen? Either they're going to drop that deal with you, or they're going to go to someone else, or they're going to come back and try to negotiate even more harder. And eventually you're losing. So to avoid that temporary pain, you're going to have a permanent loss just because you don't want to deal with it in the beginning. So take that call, understand your customer's concern, put your foot down and say no. It's always important to be transparent to your customer as long as you know that it's a win-win situation. But avoiding that conversation itself is actually creating another Pandora's box where you are going to move away from the outcome of the conversation. So don't avoid. It is, apart from the fact that it's disrespectful, it actually creates more problems for you. It makes you lose. And another third critical observation I have as to why a lot of customers a lot of entrepreneurs avoid their customers is because sometimes a customer calls and makes unreasonable demands or make unreasonable requests, which is not within the scope of what you have agreed to do. And also it's at a bad time. Like, I'll tell you what happens. Your work time is until 6:30 or 7 o'clock in the evening, and your customer will ping you or send you a message or call you at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock and will want something urgently for tomorrow, which in your head you're going like, my God, I mean, don't I have a life? I don't want to pick up the call of my customer, okay? Because it's not fair. I have my personal life too. So let me tell you how to deal with this. Should you pick up that call in the beginning? Yes. Don't avoid it, because I'll tell you what will happen because you avoid it, people will think that you don't care. You know, because I understand this mentality that customers may have sometimes, and I believe customers need ethics. So I'm a very, very big fan of that. And they may take advantage of the fact that they've paid you money. Sometimes people think that way. It's unfortunate. So when this situation happens, pick up the call. Okay, address their concern, but also make it very clear, set the right context that, you know what, henceforth, you will not be doing this, and explain to them why. That it's not fair. we are having a professional relationship, and obviously after 6:30 or 7 PM, I don't entertain work calls, so I'm going to request you to talk during business hours. So the key is to set the context so they know how to handle such situations. If not, till you clarify that, they will feel that it's okay for them to do it, and it's their right to do it if you're not clarified it. So make sure you clarify it rather than avoiding it, because avoiding it in the beginning will lead to them misinterpreting the entire action and misunderstanding you. So in summary, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, you got to treat your customer like a friend. You got to treat your customer like a partner. You got to have the relationship and connection with them so they understand that it's supposed to be a win-win situation where, like, you are addressing the needs and problems of theirs. They also need to understand what you're bringing on the table so that the equation is fair. And it's sense in educating them about it rather than avoiding them, because when you avoid, it creates more conflict, it creates more misunderstanding, and it creates issues which weren't even there. So rather solve it rather than dealing with it in a resistive manner. So if you like what I shared with you right now, please make sure that you hit the like button. Make sure you hit the subscribe button so you get access to all my videos. And make sure you share my video with a lot of other entrepreneurs so they can benefit from this and also treat their customers differently and build better relationships. In the meanwhile, I'm going to see you in my next video.